The fact of the matter is there is a lot of software on the market to handle membership, and a lot of them are good. You know, a lot of them, in my mind, I categorize them, okay, this software is great if you're just going to get to 500 members. I do it based on number of members because I imagine a ship crossing the ocean. Like if you get in a boat that has some holes in it, it can still carry you across the ocean because it's still seaworthy. But if you put more weight on it and the holes go beneath the water, now you have a problem. So I put it in terms of like, are you doing just 0 to 100 members, 0 to 500, 500 to 5,000, 5,000 and above? And I usually work and talk to and focus on people who are more doing the, you know, 1,000 and above mark, because when you're hitting those numbers, the planning and the tools you have become much more important. If you're below 1,000, you can still kind of sail a ship with holes in it. You know, in that sense, you can use any software that's on the market that works for you, that you think, because it's always going to be trade-offs. With software, there's always trade-offs. No one piece of software does everything, even MemberMouse. You know, there's some platforms that do stuff better than us. We do stuff better than other platforms. So, you know, if you're below 1,000, sometimes it can be about pricing. Like maybe you just need something that's a one-time purchase, you know, and that's what you want to do. But the thing to really keep in mind is one day, if you get successful and you break that 1,000 member mark, if your software doesn't allow you to grow and give you the flexibility to grow, then you'll need to switch. And that is a very costly process. And sometimes it's not even possible to do. So that's why the beginning is such an important time to make the correct decision.
All right, so a couple of things here. With your specific software, MemberMouse, this is a software that people could use right from the very beginning, not sure, you know, what kind of size they may grow to, as well as obviously the 1,000 plus, as you mentioned. Is that true?
Oh yeah, for sure. It's designed to be worked from the beginning, and it's actually priced that way. I mean, when MemberMouse started, we didn't have a plan below $99 a month. But now our lowest plan is $20 a month. And we did that, you know, and sometimes people make the mistake of thinking that's a value. That's how we're valuing the software, but it's really underpriced at that level. And so the reason we did that is because we wanted to support people who are just getting started in building their businesses and being able to start. So the pricing is designed such that it ratchets up as you grow. So ideally the situation is you have enough members to cover the cost. And then when you need more members, you again have the members to cover the cost. And like I said, the tools that are built into the system are designed to help, you know, which I think a lot of other speakers you have will be talking about, designed to help increase lifetime customer value. Like, and we're not the only software that does this, but if you're looking for software, definitely get something that has the ability to do one-click purchases, you know, because if you get somebody in the door as a customer, you spent so much money to get them through your traffic funnel, through your optimization of your checkout process, you know, now they've purchased something, and now it's easier for somebody who has bought from you once to have them buy from you again. And the smallest amount of friction that you can have at that point in time will result in higher conversion. So that's why one-click purchasing after they've given you their card is so valuable. So that's certainly like, that's just a no-brainer. Just like have that feature